Hello friends, welcome. I'm a Reiki master, Neil Cooper, from the West Sussex on the south coast of England, here in Bognor Regis. So today I want to talk about a healing crisis. Now, as a Reiki master or Reiki healer, you have clients or you go to a Reiki healer, and what Reiki actually does, it's holistic, so it's guided by a higher intelligence. So as healers, we're not really healers, we're more channels with that energy. It's coming from the universe and God, or God through us to the client, to the person receiving it. And that will find its own way wherever it needs to go in that person. So a heal all needs, which are physical, mental and emotional and spiritual needs, it will heal. So completely holistic, heal the whole body, mind, body and spirit. After you've had a healing or during your healing, you can have a healing crisis, which is a natural part of Reiki healing. It allows for self-healing to take place. So when you receive a Reiki healing, it'll continue working for up to 3 days after you've had that healing, and you can have a healing crisis any time in that period. So quite often it's the next day, but some people will begin to have a healing crisis during the actual healing or immediately afterwards, but most often the next morning they will have it. Now, with mental and emotional problems, you can wake up and feel really down, or you can have irritability, trauma, all kinds of things that have come to the surface, because what Reiki does, it draws that problem to the surface to be released. So you actually go through it, and you know, during the healing itself, you feel it get worse sometimes, that trauma or emotional or that physical pain. It will get worse as it's being drawn out, because the Reiki is drawing that negative emotion, that negative thought, that negative feeling, that pain of your body. It's drawing it out, and it becomes more vivid while you're actually having it. And people have all sorts of experiences during the healing. They see colours in their mind. They will feel dark clouds or negative energies coming out of them, out of their body, all over the place. They feel pains get a lot worse and more painful as it's drawn away. So they have many, many different experiences during the actual healing part itself. So, as Reiki healers, we try to advise people that, you know, don't do anything rash the next day, because you can be having a healing crisis, and, you know, that will maybe last for up to 3 days, because the healing will carry on. With some people, it's a big release the next day or straight after the healing. And with others, it takes 2 or 3 days for it really to draw that out in the way it needs to. So, yeah, be accepting of that. It is a natural part of Reiki and of the healing process. And what that's really doing, you know, we are putting those energies into us, the healer. What it's really doing is letting you self-heal. So the energy is helping you to heal yourself. It can be trauma or past things of abuse or physical conditions you're suffering. You know, it can be anything, you know, and Reiki is complementary medicine. It's classed as that, you know, but it can do wonders with one person, not so well with the next. And they can be suffering exactly the same condition, because one person's much more open to receiving it and welcome it, and another person not. They've got more barriers up. So those that put more barriers up to Reiki helping them are preventing it in some amount from helping them, because it won't come into them so well, because they've got that barrier there that's preventing it in the mind, or whatever it is, religious belief, it could be anything that's putting that barrier there. So we always say to our clients, you know, be open, you know, and accept it and let it do its best to help you, and it works better. And you know, so get a lot of that, you know, so expect that. You know, expect a healing crisis. If you know, you won't always have one, it's not always the case, but some people have a healing and feel no effect from it, other than they feel a bit happier maybe, or they feel relaxed afterwards. So not so many needs, you know, but the more needs you got, the bigger the healing crisis quite often will be. So yeah, anyway, you know, that's the client side of it, you know. And you can have a whole array of different experiences from a healing crisis, as I say, you can have depression the next day, or trauma, or irritability, or, you know, physical feelings. You can have an upset stomach. You can have intense tingles all over your body that are quite uncomfortable, but it's the healing crisis, the healing process. Maybe it's a lot of toxins in your body that are being released and different things. So we ask you to drink plenty of water after a Reiki healing, you know, to help flush out toxins, because it does release blood flow around your body much, much more. And the blood flows into joints. That's how it helps to heal the joints. You know, the Reiki healing does a part for a joint, but the blood flow increased to that joint will help heal it as well. But it'll flush out toxins too. So, you know, you can go through all sorts of different experiences with this. Now, I'd also like to talk about Reiki students when they're getting ready and preparing for their attunements. Initiation, that's where the Reiki master attunes them and gives them an initiation into Reiki to reconnect them with that Reiki life force. Now, they are usually told by a Reiki master, you know, stay away from certain things for at least, some say a fortnight, mostly I say a week. Stay away from red meats, only eat white meats. Try to eat plenty of salad and vegetables, fruit juice, all real healthy eating for a week before your attunement, your initiation into Reiki. And, you know, don't drink alcohol for a week. Don't smoke for a week. That's what most Reiki masters will teach. But I say don't smoke for at least 48 hours if you can manage it. At the worst, 24 hours. Don't smoke cannabis for 48 hours before that. If you're taking harder drugs than that, do not do Reiki, because you're not right for it. You're not fit for it. If you're taking harder drugs, keep taking prescription drugs. We don't want you to stop them. That's okay. Reiki accepts that. Remember, it's a higher intelligence. It knows what you're doing. So, yeah, you've got to live clean, be clean for your Reiki attunement, or you'll have a healing crisis during the attunement. You know, because you are not ready for it and you've been cheating, and it's going to know that because it's a higher intelligence. Some say it's God consciousness, things like this. It knows exactly what you have and haven't done. And if you're not ready, it's going to try and heal you. That's what happens during the attunement, or just before. It tries to heal you and put you right for the attunement, and you're not right. And, you know, it's much different to the healing crisis that a client might get. Because the healing crisis you will have will be immensely quick, and it will make you get very hot. You'll start sweating, you'll feel nauseous, you what most likely will vomit and be sick. So this happens to Reiki healers too that are not right for healing. Same thing. You know, they can be, you know, have done their attunement, go out to heal the first person, maybe they've healed, or they've gone on the wrong path for a little while, go back to healing, you know, where they've been abusing themselves or something, you know, taking drugs or whatever it might be, or they've got emotional issues that, you know, have come up and different things. They start healing and they get a healing crisis, and they get hot, they start sweating, nauseous, start vomiting, you know, have to get out of there. And, you know, that's a healing crisis for a healer or a attunee, you know what I mean, if they've been cheating. So I had a woman that I attuned distantly on a webcam, and I was just doing the meditation beforehand to get her ready for the actual attunement. And I'd said to her all these things, you know, don't eat red meat and all this and that. And she got very ill during the meditation, preparing her for the attunement. She had a healing crisis. She got hot, she started sweating, she got nauseous, she vomited in the end. So, and then we stopped. I had to draw all that Reiki energy back out of her. We left it. I said, maybe we'll do it again in a couple of weeks, try again. And then she wrote to me the next day. She says, you told me not to smoke, and I had given up, but 2 days before the attunement, I started smoking again, and I had a cigarette 5 minutes before you come on here and did the meditation with me. So the Reiki knew she was cheating and, you know, just had a cigarette, and it was trying immensely to heal her, to get her ready for the attunement. So, you know what I mean? You can't cheat these things. It's a higher force. It knows what you're doing. And, yeah, do it right. You know, if you're going to do it right. And, you know, like I say, if you're taking hard drugs out there, you should never be a healer. You know what I mean? You've got to get off of that, and you've got to self-heal before you become a Reiki healer, of course. So, you know, it's a pathway, and you've got to have a certain amount of purity in yourself to walk that path, because it's a spiritual gift, isn't it? So yeah, so that's what can happen to Reiki students if they're cheating on getting ready and preparing for their attunement, and they should be meditating every day too, you know what I mean. So I do the Reiju with mine too before they come, which is like putting the Reiki energy into them and back out through a video or here in person. So, yeah, but, you know, be accepting of the process of Reiki, that as a client, you know, receiving healing, you very likely will have a healing crisis if you're with a healer that is putting a good amount of healing into you. It will naturally draw those things to the surface, and you know, you're going to have that. It's releasing these things. It's getting them out of your system. And then you feel much, much better afterwards, you know, because, you know, all this past trauma's coming out and, you know, it's gone and it's left behind you. And you feel so much more positive and relieved and happier because of it. And, you know, so you've been, you know, abused by, you know, maybe a relation or a partner or whoever that is. It can bring that out. It can let you release it. You can move on with your life, you know, so that's the way it is. Anyway, I hope you, you know, enjoyed that, and it's given you some insight into what a Reiki healing crisis is. And I say, it's a natural part of the Reiki system. So love and light to you. Bless you. Neil.